Alright guys, seems like this device ain't on. As soon as it comes on, TGIF, I'm gonna give it to you, but we are on channel 19, man, no doubt about it. And, lo and behold, it's politics on 1-9 from New York City's Junkie Boys. To repeat, the guys that speak 100 words but have no point and have to repeat. Dope fiends and homos. The bad girl. But you know what?
The fucking veterans, what's the book for this fucking country? The people who fucking work and born and raised in this country. Look out for them first, you know? Fucking so much fucking homeless, but you got veterans in the street. Why they can't sleep in a whole fucking hotel or get a fucking apartment? Why they gotta go? You know what I'm saying? It's just fucking ridiculous.
200 million enemy combatants on the soil.
You know, whether it's fucking Democrats, Republicans, I mean, this whole ICE, man. I can't believe the way it is.
TGIF. 9:10 in the PM. New York City. Enforcer 2-5 above. No truth and justice.
He's not going to Ohio where they had that train derailment. All those chemicals that fucked up the soil, the drinking water, the well water. You got people's animals, livestock, dead. And these fucking clowns don't even go there and visit that state, Ohio. California, Ohio. It's a disgrace. It really is. There's no other word for it. Trump went there. And he's not even the president.
Like anybody who's rich.
All right, when you have a disaster like that, 30 days later, you got this clown that just went there as the head of, you know, dealing with the, the railroads and whatnot. He just went over there. I tell you, man, I've never seen such disrespect towards American people. Places that they sent me to give me an apartment or you know, place to live. But
fucking, you know, Rockaway and shit. You know, she got kids, I don't know. I don't get shit like that, man. I don't get it. Then you got, again, military, you got vets. Fucking in the street. Not getting fucking help, but they helping out everybody and their mother. This shit is fucked up, man. It is all fucked up, man. I tell you, to me, I'm sorry. This president, you know, not president, but there should be an age limit, man, for these fucking presidents, bro. These motherfuckers are all old. What the fuck is going on here, man? You can see he can barely walk. You know what I'm saying? I'm fucking hugging out that fucking guy, the president of fucking Ukraine, hugging out his fucking president. What's going on here, man? Like, yo, enough is enough. I mean, yeah, I feel for those people, but you know what? That's not our fucking problem. That's their fucking problem.
You know what's even a bigger disgrace is that one of the things that Trump pushed the allies is that 2% of his GDP, they weren't even paying. So basically, America was paying all this money to protect Europe and our European allies and fighting wars, and these cocksuckers weren't paying their 2%, and they're not doing it again because it is clowns in office. You know, they try to flip it.
Went through some hard times, fought for the fucking country, and they don't do jack shit for them. said, oh yeah, we're doing this, doing that. Come on, man.
Oh shit, they understand in Richie. Now that's what I call full control.
Why they keep going back? Because there's nowhere else to go. Your guy is so busy helping everybody and their mother from someplace else, but these people are here fucked up. They got no choice. You know, I mean, the subway system is unbelievable, man. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, some of the stuff that this mayor, you know, he's right. He's like, yo, you know, we need help here. You know, there's only so much we can do, but they keep just sending people, helping this person, giving. Let me tell you that. If we were to go into a war right now, you think we got the fucking arms, you know, the arms to fucking really get in there with every shit we fucking put out there? Come on, man. They already said they damn near depleted our munitions. If we had to go into a new war or face defend Taiwan, we wouldn't even have the capacity to fight a special war. Because let me tell you, war, this is already World War III. That Nord Stream pipeline, America blew up, and that's been proven. All right, that's been proven. They disguised it as a NATO exercise, and they blew that shit up, that pipeline that goes from Russia to Germany. So if you don't call that a terrorist act, what the fuck do you call that? And you know, big bad America, we can get away with it because we got it like that. You know, it's bullshit. You know, listen, I'm no fan of Trump, but you know what? When I saw the stats that more people in Russia support Putin than Americans support Joe Biden, look what that tells you right there. And I don't know if you know the press secretary, she slipped at the president. That shit would have happened. China, this is all to see how fucking strong we are, right? I say this is all a fucking test, bro. They want to see how shit is, because why would fucking China want to fucking back up Russia? That's a whole fucking cahoot, and I don't trust that fucking Ukrainian nigga. He could be with fucking Putin and just fucking, you know, pulling strings. Oh, yeah, we need help. And he's just showing them equipment and selling them equipment we fucking giving them. You know, or see what we got. I'm like, come on, man. You know what I'm saying? And look it, Russia's already tested a fucking nuclear warhead. Fucking people. I tell you, man, nobody reads the fine print, man. You know, there's so many fucking stupid ass motherfuckers, man. I tell you. That's why I want to get the fuck out of here, man. I want to get out of here as fast as I fucking can, man. I'm fucking tired of the bullshit, tired of the city. You know, I mean, listen. If they fucking Armageddon starts, like you said, yeah, World War III has been started. Yeah, look at, there's no coming back once the stupid asses start fucking launching shit. You know, but we too busy giving shit away, giving, you know, fucking shit to, you know, fuck that. Yeah, I can't anymore. This is so fucked up. It's ridiculous. China's sitting back. They're watching. They're seeing. And then, dumb fuck. And they, forget the fucker. They should have, man, they should have shot that shit down. You know, and you could imagine what the fuck. I mean, I'm waiting, because they said they got one of those balloons that got everything that was with it, whatever. Yeah, I want to see what kind of intelligence was sent back to fucking China, you know, man. Well, I mean, we a fucking joke, man. We a fucking joke. The United States is not a superpower like it used to be. You know what I'm saying? And it's true. They could rain as many fucking missiles, of course. But, you know, you gotta have a fucking 1,000 fucking different types of fucking missiles. Of course some of them gonna get it. You're not gonna be able to get it. You're not gonna be able to get everything. You know, just like us, whatever we fucking throw up there, some stuff we're gonna get knocked down, some stuff we're gonna make it through. But that's just it. Once they start with that shit, there's no coming back for none of this bullshit. You know, and definitely, you know, China's fucking sitting back because they looking, they trying to see how good is our shit compared to theirs. And they fucking pushing. They pushing for it. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be a crazy ass shit, man. But hey, you put some, regardless, you know, yeah, moving on is fucking, yeah, he got old ass fucking equipment and shit like that, but you know what? He's still fucking doing damage. Yeah, it's a year later. But he would have been conquered Ukraine if it wasn't for us sending our shit over there. You know what I'm saying? You know, I mean, but still, put them two together, Russia and China. Yeah, you know what I mean. Who's the other biggest ally we got is fucking England, right? England, because, and even their fucking equipment is fucking outdated compared to our shit.
Yeah, what really bothers me is that, you know, when everything's on a head trigger right now. You got the South China Sea, you got two aircraft carriers over there. Chinese aircraft carrier that met up. You know, all it takes is, you know, someone to make a harsh decision or you know what I'm saying? Some rogue captain on one of the ships decides he wants to deploy a missile at one of our ships. That's all it takes. It just takes one incident like that to set off World War III. But, I couldn't believe it, man. They were saying that fucking China has 340 naval vessels. We have less than 300. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. I can't believe it, man. And all these companies cut the military budget. Yeah, well, you know, keep sending money abroad. Another thing is this fucking Paris Accord, this Green New Deal. You know, they're telling you that you can't have gas stoves. You know, they're telling you that, global warming. Let me tell you, that's all a bunch of bullshit. Because the biggest offenders of global warming is China and India. And neither one of them even are part of that, that France Accord. You know, where they go, you know, all these countries. NATO countries not paying their 2%. gotta go to the gutter. Ain't saying jack, but they just beating around the fucking bush because they want to keep you blind. You know what I'm saying? You know, this is all fucking bullshit. And then this fucking asshole, that other fucking, what's up with that Santos motherfucker? Get him the fuck out of here. What the fuck? This fucking country is fucking going, it's been going downhill for so long, it's like ridiculous, man. Ridiculous. And again, yeah, why the fuck do these fucking NATO people, you know, we pay 5%, they only get to pay 2%, and then they're not even fucking paying. You know, that's another reason why we're fucking so fucking, we in debt, because people not fucking paying their fucking shit. You know what I'm saying? You know, but everybody, America, yeah, they're helping. America, they're helping. Shit. And well, the way they're looking at America is just like a big whore. Everyone around the world looks at America like we're just a big whore grabbing our ankles and just getting fucked. Look at this fucking governor Hogan. She's a fucking retard. That bitch looks evil. And then you got this DA, this black. This motherfucker don't put anyone in jail. It's like, just do what you want. These DAs, this fucking George Soros, he got these DAs for him. He got them in his pocket. I forget what state it was. It's that they want to this DA out because she's not even doing her job. I mean, criminals are just running rampant. And, you know, they don't even keep them in jail. And then the next thing, they're out there killing people. And they're like, see, look at the record of this person. Yeah, I'm not saying a lot of people are for stupid crimes like fucking marijuana possession. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about violent crimes. I'm talking about attempted murder. I'm like, wow. Yeah, you don't go to jail for major shit like that, man. What is that telling the criminal?
Yeah, let me go after that guy, man. All those black cops beating that guy. Motherfucker has no record, no nothing. And you know, it's fucked up, man. It's fucked up. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, damn. And they were taking pictures of him while they beat this fucking guy down. You know, like, it's fucked up. It doesn't matter. You know? When you say corrupt, it's corrupt. That's just how it is. You know? But at the same time, I tell people this, man. When a cop pulls you over, whatever, don't fucking run, don't talk, just listen to what they gotta say, and all you say, yes, sir. You need my license? You need my ID? No problem, sir. That's it. Keep it. You make your day go easy and smoother. But no, you're gonna get stupid. Oh, why are you pulling me over? What did I do? Shut the fuck up, you know? I mean, it's fucked up what they did to him, you know? But he took off, too. Like, yo, just fucking wait, see what's going on, you know? Just fucking don't say shit, you know? I mean, and that fucking governor, that chick, yeah, she still looks fucked up, man. I don't trust her ass either, man. I tell you, man, this fucking country, the shit that's going on, man, it's just beyond me, man. And people are eating that shit up, man, thinking it's cool. I'm like, man, nobody sees what the fuck is going on, huh? You know? It's like everybody want to play deaf, blind, nobody gives a shit. Everybody wants to get fucking high, you know, be stupid. Everybody's fighting for stupid shit. I'm like, man, you don't see what the fuck is going on, huh? Okay, everybody's playing that blind shit.
You know that narrative that they're pushing, white supremacy and systemic racism, that's their narrative. That's what they're pushing the Democrats. Because they want to, you know, they say conquer and divide. Divide and conquer, that's their narrative. And let me tell you, that situation with those five cops and that young man that got executed, because that's what I call it. He was baiting, or there was some kind of dispute with him, you know.
up, he put pressure to his neck, but, you know, he was fucked up. You know what I'm saying? I mean, yeah, it didn't have to happen to him either, but, you know, it is a fucking shame. No matter, it doesn't matter what color you are, I keep saying the same fucking thing. Authorities pull you over, just shut the fuck up, listen to them, do what they want you to do, and that's it. So you open your mouth, boy, you fucking wave your hand, get ready. Just stay the fuck still. Listen to what they gotta say. Now, you're not doing nothing, and they fucking wind up beating on you, whatever, don't do shit, don't fight like that. Don't worry, you're gonna have your day. You know, but when you start talking shit, you start opening your mouth, don't listen to, let them do their fucking job, because these fucking guys out here too. You know, they scared too. You know, they scared. You know, mistakes happen. But the best thing you can do is just be calm, man. Be calm, man. And it's just fucked up, man. Everything that's going on, fucking shit with black, white, Spanish, it's just bullshit. And that's what they want. They want to keep everybody fucking divided. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, fuck that. Now when we grew up, everybody was together, we still fucking together. I mean, it's a shame that people play the blind eye to shit. A lot of fucking shit happening, but this is the world we live in, man. You know what I'm saying? You gotta be careful, you gotta do what you gotta do. And it's making it harder because, you know, nobody trusts the police anymore. It's not the same. You know what I'm saying? It's fucking crazy. And it's fucked up too because, again, I got family on the fucking job. Do I want them to get hurt for fucking somebody making a mistake? No. You know what I'm saying? Not all fucking authorities fucked up, but, you know, come on, man. Enough is enough with the bullshit.
Yeah, and also a problem that people don't realize, that cop that was involved with the woman, and this kid was a young guy this guy was an NCO, he was a correction officer, and he had multiple occurrences of abuse, all right? And you think they would tag that, you understand? But you know what happens? When you're desperate to recruit new cops, they get the bottom of the barrel. So those cops shouldn't even been on the force, you know? So, you know, when you're rejected as a correction officer, and then you enter the force, and they see that, they have to know his record. Because all that documents of the life, you know, fuck it, man, we need cops, you know, because no one wants to do this job anymore. So that's what you have. You have a false selection now. And it has nothing to do with color. It just has to do with character and the type of personnel that you have left to choose from.
Yeah. Just like over here, the corrections is all fucked up over here, man. You see all the shit's going on in fucking Rikers, you know, it's like, we got the COs fucking dealing drugs, COs are killing niggas, niggas are killing the COs. I mean, you tell me, you got these niggas fucking locked up, all these motherfuckers, and how the fuck does a handful get out and stop beating up on the COs? Or the fucking COs eat shit. See a nigga hanging, they don't even say nothing, just keep working on fire. I mean, it's fucking crazy, bro. Bringing shit from the outside, selling things. Alright, man, it is so fucking corrupt. Anywhere you look at it, it's ridiculous, man.
Yeah, they had a news conference, and they had hundreds and hundreds of cell phones on the table. You know, when they do their sweep and they confiscate shit, they had shanks, homemade weapons, and you have to see this, the amount of cell phones that they had on the table. You know when they have that program, turn in a weapon for money. But they have cell phones that they, like, how the hell do you think all that shit's getting in drugs and cell phones and so on and so forth? There's no other way. Listen, right, it's just human nature. People are corrupt. I kid around and I talked to one of my former co-workers. I said, yo, when we retire, man, let's go to the border. Yeah, these fucking cartels are paying good money, and these motherfuckers are making $60 million a week. Yeah, can't comprehend numbers like that. You know, I'm joking, of course. But, you know, this American citizen that is driving the trailer, and they hit him up, yeah, it's 100 G's to fill up the back of this trailer with illegals and go about your business. And that's what a lot of that shit's happening, man. These guys pay big money. These cartels are running the border, I hate to say it. We don't even have control of our southern border. Now they're going to the northern border, fucking between U.S. and Canada. We're having problems because of our power. The numbers of patrol agents on the northern border are depleted.
Yeah, I saw that shit too, man. You seen that documentary of When They See Us about the Central Park Five? Oh, man, that's just to tell you, this shit that went on, all the fucking... And, you know, it's crazy, because to this day, that fucking blonde-haired lady, that fucking DA, whatever, she's been fucking guilty. I'm like, wow. The guy, the original guy that fucking did that girl, not his kid, gave himself up, told him, and she's still... And she still blames those fucking guys. I mean, oh, man, it's yo, let me tell you, man, it's city, man. Just the way it is, man. It's always going to be like that. Nothing changes. And it's just getting worse and worse, man. But it's fucked up because these motherfuckers are shooting people, getting back out the next day. So the guy, well, I forgot, I know it was one. His friend was shot, so he goes, don't worry, my lawyer still has me out back tomorrow.
I'm like, what the fuck?
This motherfucker just killed somebody, and he's out the next day.
You know, like I said, man, you got people in power that are fucking evil. I won't even use the word corrupt. They're evil. This Nancy Pelosi, she's a fucking witch. I'm telling you, these people are evil. Forget about corrupt. Corrupt is being polite. These motherfuckers are just damn evil. You know, they say don't use soap, right? Gas is no good for your life, and yet you feel that mankind's ready to annihilate each other. Let's just shut them all down. You know what I'm saying? And they got robots that can repair other robots. We're already at that stage. So, again, we're not going somewhere, you know? It's fiction. It's no longer science fiction. We're coming to reality. And people better start, you know, opening their eyes and start worrying about the next model iPhone that comes out. And worry about what's really important. Because, I'm telling you, man, if it's not the next virus that's going to get us, it's going to be artificial intelligence and advanced robotics.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. Like I say, Skynet, man, Skynet. Give me a second, my daughter's just on the phone. Give me a second, I'll be back.
Roger.
250. I'm gonna have to catch up with you, ma'am. I'm gonna have to go test seven. But I'll talk to you tomorrow. You out there? You copy?
Oh, the politically incorrect junkie hour's over? Damn it, boy. Courtesy of your hole in the wall, now in Crooklyn, Brooklyn, New York, CB Shop, full control.